सी सॉफ्टवेयर टेस्टिंग रियल टाइम इंटरव्यू क्वेश्चंस। फर्स्ट वन, व्हाट आर द की चैलेंजेस ऑफ सॉफ्टवेयर टेस्टिंग दैट यू फेस्ड इन योर करियर? व्हाट आर द की चैलेंजेस ऑफ सॉफ्टवेयर टेस्टिंग दैट यू फेस्ड इन योर करियर? आई हैव फेस्ड सो मेनी चैलेंजेस इन माई टेस्टिंग करियर। One is unstable application under test, time constraints, understanding and analyzing test requirements, next, changing requirements, lack of domain knowledge and business user perspective understanding, business user perspective understanding. Prioritizing test cases, lack of skilled team members, selecting test cases for regression testing, lack of resources and training, next, test environment issues. Okay, next, how you derived test cases? That depends on project. Sometimes we derive test cases from requirements, sometimes from use cases. Depends on project. See, in my current project, I derive test cases using test requirements. Next, how many test cases did you write for your previous project? Nearly 170 test cases. Next, how much time is required to write a test case? That depends on complexity of the functionality. Some test cases take 5 to 10 minutes, some take half an hour to 45 minutes also. See, that depends on complexity of the functionality. Next, how many defects did you detect in your last project? I executed nearly 150 test cases. Some are complex test cases, some are simple test cases, in which some 22 defects were raised, including 3 showstoppers. Okay, next. Did you face any problems during defect reporting and tracking? Yes, developers rejected 2 or 3 valid defects. See, developers were rejected 2 or 3 my valid defects. Next, did you create a requirements traceability matrix document in your project? No, my test lead created that RTM document. I only updated the document. I updated the requirement traceability matrix document. Next, did you involve in test environment setup? Yes, I involved in verifying test lab setup along with other team members. See, my test lead define a test environment setup. Technical support people implemented that test environment. We team members verified that test environment setup before test execution. Next, did you perform any live testing? Yes, in my current project, we used live data for some test cases. Next, what is the difference between front-end testing and back-end testing? Front-end testing is performed on the graphical user interface, whereas back-end testing involves database testing. We conduct database testing using SQL queries. Database testing is a subset of functional testing. Next, what is the difference between system testing and functional testing? Difference between system testing and functional testing. System testing is a test level. Functional testing is a test type that can be performed in all levels of testing. Functional testing is a test type that can be performed in all levels of testing. Unit testing, integration testing, system testing, and acceptance testing. System testing is test level. Functional testing is a test type. Next, what is the difference between performance testing and load testing? See, load testing, stress testing, spike testing, and endurance testing all are subsets of performance testing. Load testing is subset of performance testing. Next, what are the test types that you performed in your software testing career? See, in my testing career, I performed functionality testing, performance testing, security testing, usability testing, compatibility testing, browser compatibility and OS operating system compatibility. Next, installation testing, testing installation process and uninstallation process. Next, what are the test deliverables? See, what documentation we produce during testing, all commander test deliverables. Test plan document, test scenarios, test cases, test data, opened and closed defect reports, test matrix reports, and test summary report, etc. Next, did you involve in test plan documentation? Yes, I involved in test plan documentation in the last project. Identified features to be tested, entry criteria, exit criteria, and suspension criteria for my project. Next, what is exhaustive testing? Exhaustive testing, testing with all possible inputs and preconditions. Testing with all possible inputs and preconditions is called exhaustive testing, and it is impractical. So we use test design techniques to reduce the size of input and output domains. Next, what are the important phases in software test process or software test life cycle? Important phases in formal software test process. Test planning, test design, test execution. Next, evaluating exit criteria and test closure. Test planning, test design, test execution, evaluating exit criteria and test closure. Next, what are the important tasks in test planning phase? Important tasks in test planning phase. Understanding and analyzing the requirements. Understanding and analyzing test requirements. Risk analysis. Test strategy implementation. Next, test estimations by considering scope of the project, time, available environmental and human resources, and budget. By considering scope, time, resources, and budget, test estimations. Next, team formation, test plan documentation, Next, configuration management planning, traceability matrix, documentation. Next, define test environment setup. These are the important tasks in test planning phase of software test process or software test life cycle. Next, what are the important tasks in test design phase? Understanding requirements, generating test scenarios. Next, test case documentation, test data collection. Next, what are test design techniques that you used? So far I used a black box test design techniques, equivalence class partitioning, boundary value analysis is the extension of equivalent classes. Next, decision table testing. Next, state transition testing. These are the black box test design techniques, and I also used some experienced basic techniques for some projects, error guessing and exploratory testing. Next, how you communicate with the developers to resolve issues. That depends on company and sometimes depends on project. In my current project, I'm communicating developers via our test lead. Next, what is configuration management? Did you use any configuration management tool in your testing career? Storing and organizing all configurable items is called configuration management. It is not only for testing team, also for all stakeholders of the project, development team, project management, business analyst, etc. All stakeholders of the project. Next, it is very important for development team than testing team. I used VSS, Visual Source Safe, tool for configuration management in my last project. Next, you told configurable items. What are configurable items in software test process? What software and hardware we use and what documents we produce during testing, all are come under configurable items. What software and hardware we use and what documents we produce during testing, all come under configurable items. Next, when we choose informal testing, whenever we don't have proper documentation, example requirements, etc., and sufficient time, then we choose informal testing. Using experience-based techniques, example error guessing and exploratory testing, we conduct informal testing. Next, what are the important test types that can be applied for web applications? Say, functionality testing, security testing, compatibility testing, navigation testing, database testing, reliability testing, usability testing, recovery testing. Next, performance testing. All these are applicable on web-based applications, web applications. Next, do you have experience in database testing? Yes, I conducted database testing manually using SQL commands. I tested the following database operations during database testing: data manipulations, addition, updation, deletion of records, data manipulations, add, edit, delete records. Next, data integrity. Next, data retrievals and data comparisons, etc. operations. Thank you.